Hey everyone, I'm Sam from Professional Music Technology.
And I'm Meg.
And in this week's vlog, seeing as the summer holidays are over and it's the start of a new school year, we're ticking off a list of essential back to school items.
So if you are learning music at school or college, here is some of our top recommendations for the best affordable beginner's instruments and all the accessories you'll need to go with them.
Right, so here we are on the shop floor of PMT Portsmouth, and the first item on our list is an electric guitar. So that's kind of my department. Let's head over and check out all the electric guitars. So there are a few things that you probably want to look out for when you're buying your first electric guitar. A lot of the times, especially when parents are in kind of buying guitars for younger kids, they just want to know what our cheapest guitar is. But to be honest, if you want the kid to stick with it, it's probably better spending a little bit more. You still don't have to spend loads, but a little bit more gets you a better quality instrument, which means they're going to find it easier to play and probably more likely to stick with it. So the things that you probably want to look out for, firstly, the action, which is the height of the strings above the fretboard here. If that's too high, that's going to be really difficult to press down and make your fingers sore. You also want to check out the frets running up the edge of the neck here. Make sure that they're nice and smooth. On a lot of cheaper guitars, they do tend to be quite jagged, and again, that can be quite painful to play, and I've even seen instances where your fingers kind of get cut up. Up on the headstock, you want to make sure that the machine heads, or the tuners, that's these bits here, are nice and smooth and they're not jumping, and this means that you'll be able to tune up accurately and the guitar will stay in tune. Similarly, down on the bridge, make sure there's nothing rattling about and that there's no sharp edges that are going to make it uncomfortable to play. So the guitar we're looking at here is the East Coast GS100. It's one of the best quality electric guitars at this kind of price point that we keep in stock here at PMT. And as you can see, it's got that kind of classic Fender Stratocaster vibe to it. Or if you did want something a little bit different, there's the GT100, which is more of a kind of Telecaster shape. Both the GS100 and the GT100 are available in a few different finishes. So if you are after a cheap but good quality electric guitar, they're definitely worth checking out. Another great option, which is definitely worth considering, especially if you are a younger or a smaller player, is something like this Squire Bullet Mustang. And the reason for this is because it's a short scale guitar. If you don't know what I'm talking about, the scale length of a guitar is the distance between the bridge and the nut up the top here. And this one is a shorter 24 inch. Yeah, 24 inch? Yes, yep. It is 24 inch, isn't it? 24 inches on a Mustang, as opposed to 25.5 inches that you find on a Telecaster or a Stratocaster. So this means that with that shorter scale length, there's less distance for you to reach down to the lower frets. So if you do have shorter arms, it's less of a stretch. It also means that there's less tension on the strings, so they're much easier to bend. And they've got a thinner neck, so if you've got smaller fingers, it makes it much easier to get your fingers wrapped around the neck. Plus, shorter scale guitars do also tend to have smaller, more compact bodies. So overall, it's much more lightweight and compact feeling than a lot of the other electric guitars that we sell. So they're ideal for kids. Of course, if you are buying an electric guitar, you're also going to need an amplifier. So to make things nice and easy, we've got a couple of complete starter kits that we definitely recommend. The first of which is the Fender Squire Stratocaster pack. So you get a genuine Squire by Fender Stratocaster and a 15 watt amplifier, which is going to be loud enough for playing at home or just having quiet jams with your mates. And you also get a gig bag, 10 foot cable, strap and picks. Or if you did want to spend a little bit more, the Yamaha Pacifica 112s are always popular. These are great quality, solid body guitars with a humbucker pickup at the bridge. So it's gonna give you a kind of rockier tone. And these come with a much better quality amplifier. So you get a Spider 30 by Line 6, which gives you multiple channels for either clean or dirty tones and built-in effects. And they sound great. Now, I will admit that even though these starter pack amplifiers are going to sound great at low volumes, they're not quite going to be loud enough to compete with a drum kit. So if you are playing concerts or rehearsing with a band, our top pick for a guitar amplifier is going to be the Boss Katana. Now, these have been around for a couple of years. They're on the Mark II model now. And there's actually a complete range to choose from. So if you did want a small portable travel amp, you've got the Boss Katana Mini. But for louder gigs, you want to be looking at either the 50, the 100, or the 100 2x12. So this one here is the 100 watt model. It's packed full of features. So you've got different amp models, clean, crunch, lead, and then a really high gain brown sound channel. Lots of classic Boss effects that are fully customizable via the app that you can connect the amp to. And our favorite feature is the power control. So this can be turned right down to 0.5 watts if you need to use it for quiet home practicing. You've got a 50 watt mode, or full 100 watts will give you a really loud amplifier if you do need to crank it up to compete with that drum kit. So that was some of our top recommendations for entry-level to intermediate six-string electric guitars and amplifiers. But we've also got some great options if you wanted to learn the bass guitar. So just for any parents watching who might not know the difference between a guitar and a bass guitar, these are standard kind of six-string electric guitars. As you can see, they've got six thin strings. And these are bass guitars, which normally have four strings, but you can get five and six-string variants as well. The strings on a bass guitar are much thicker than you find on a standard guitar, and they're tuned an octave lower, hence why they're known as bass guitars. Just like the electric guitars, bass guitars are available in complete starter packs. Again, this is a Squire by Fender, so you can see it's their iconic P bass guitar, and that comes with a 15 watt amplifier and again a gig bag and all the accessories. Or for another great option, we'd always recommend checking out the Ibanez GSR 200 range, which again are great value basses, but they come with a few extra features such as active electronics, so you get a few more tonal options, making them a bit more versatile. And then if you couple that with something like an Ashdown Studio 10, which is a super lightweight 60 watt bass amp, then you've got a great bass rig, which is ideal for practicing at home as well as jamming in a band at school or college. Right, so we've ticked off electric guitars and bass guitars. Next up is acoustic guitars, which is Meg's department. Let's go find her.
So I've picked out some acoustic options for if you are getting lessons at school or college. And like Sam mentioned previously, there are some things with acoustic guitars you also want to look out for when you're buying your first one or the one you want to learn on. So as Sam said, the fret edges are important. Often in cheaper acoustic guitars, you get quite rough fret edges. So you want to make sure these are nice and smooth. Again, a nice low action will help you when you're playing at the beginning or early stages of guitar. And you want to make sure that the bridge is not too high down here as well, but there's always experts in stores that can help you with this sort of thing if you are not sure. This one in my hand is from an Ibanez starter pack, which is a good way to look if you are buying your first acoustic. So you usually get a gig bag and a tuner and a spare set of strings in there. But this is a Dreadnought body shape, so it may be a little on the big side for some of the sort of smaller kids or anyone with smaller hands like myself. So I'm just going to show you a Tanglewood that's also a good option.
as this one has a slightly curvier body, so when you're in store it's worth trying the guitars out for size. This one is slightly more curvy, so I find these a bit more comfortable to play. Something else to also consider is whether you want to start on an acoustic guitar or a classical guitar. So the main differences being you have nylon strings on a classical guitar and a slightly smaller scale length and a wider fretboard. Acoustic guitars have steel strings, a slightly narrower neck, and a generally louder and punchier sound. So if you are looking to play any of the mainstream, like pop or rock sort of genres, generally acoustic guitars are better, but classical guitars with the nylon strings can be a lot softer on the fingers. So if you are in the early stages of playing, a lot of people will decide to start on a classical, so it's not quite as tough on your hands. You do get a couple of options on sizes for classicals as well, so this is a full size one. But if you are looking for something for your little one who's just starting out, this is a half size, and you can also get three quarter size. So the scale length of these are a lot shorter, the neck's a lot narrower, but it still has nylon strings, so it's still very soft on the fingers when you're playing. Looking at the guitars I've mentioned, this is a Jose Ferrer half size classical. They also do a three quarter size one. And the nice thing about these is they come with a gig bag in a starter pack, but they come in at under £100. So they're ideal for your first classical guitar. If you did want to start on a full size classical though, something like this Cordoba C1M would be ideal. It's got solid spruce top and it's full size, so overall the sound is very punchy and bright. Going back to the steel string options I showed you earlier, this Ibanez is a VN50, which comes from the starter pack, which comes with the gig bag and spare set strings and a strap, everything you need to get you going. But if you do want something that's a little bit different looking, then we love these Epiphones. These are called the Starling and they are also part of a starter pack, so you get all the accessories you need with them. But they're based on the Epiphone and Gibson Hummingbirds. Obviously this one is a lot more affordable. Next up on our back to school shopping list is the ukulele, which is quickly becoming a staple at most UK schools and the instrument that a lot of kids are first learning. That's replacing the recorder, which I'm sure many parents are pleased to hear. There's nothing worse than 30 kids all trying to play Three Blind Mice on a recorder first thing in the morning. So the ukuleles have taken their place and they are an excellent instrument. They are small, compact, they only have four strings and they are super easy to learn. So this one in my hands is a Brunswick ukulele. It's nice and compact as it is soprano size. It also comes in a range of funky colours, which means you'll look super cool at school. And they come in at around £30, which is an ideal price for your first ukulele or your first instrument. And compared to some of the cheaper unbranded ukuleles you can get on the internet, these ones are great quality, stay in tune and play really well. Right, so we've checked out some of the best options for acoustic guitars, electric guitars and ukuleles, but next on our list is the accessories. So let's go check out what accessories we're gonna need. Firstly, one of the key things you will need to get your guitars to and from school or college is a decent gig bag. So some of the things you'll want to look for is that it's padded to keep your guitar protected, that it's got some comfortable and padded straps on the back so you can wear it like this. And also it's pretty helpful to have a pocket or a storage option on there so you can carry your music books and any of your accessories like a tuner or a strap in the pockets. This one is a Tourtec gig bag and comes in at only £20, so it's super affordable. Another useful thing to have on your shopping list is a guitar strap. All of our PMT stores are fully stocked with a big range of guitar straps to choose from, and it's a great way to personalise your instrument. They generally start at around £5 and go all the way up. This one here is my personal favourite.
Suits ya.
Thank you. So the same goes for cables. We also have a huge selection, but we would recommend going for either a 10-foot or a 20-foot Tourtec cable as they are super affordable, but they also have a 5-year warranty just in case anything does go wrong with your cable. Along with a strap and a cable, it's also really useful to have a spare set of strings. So the standard gauge for an electric is usually 9 or 10 gauge. For the acoustic, it's usually 11s or 12s. For the electrics, we'd recommend going for something like the Rotor Sounds as you get an extra high E in the pack, which would be useful when you will inevitably break some strings at the early stages of learning guitar. Something else that is also really useful for guitarists to have is a guitar tuner. So this Didario is a clip-on tuner, which we'd recommend using. They just clip onto the headstock of your guitar, they run off batteries, and they are super easy to use. They are also super affordable and come in a range of different designs and colours. Definitely something that is worth having in your gig bag. And they can be used to not only tune guitar and bass, you can also tune ukuleles and other stringed instruments like violins with these as well. So the final accessory that is super useful if you are taking music lessons at school is a music stand. So there is a few different options you can choose from. This one at the back is an orchestral music stand, so it's great for any heavy books or big folders if you are singing with a choir. But if you need something that's more compact and folds away, then these ones are under £15 and you can fold them up. So they're easily transportable to get to and from your music lessons at school.
So that's guitarists covered. Next up, I've chosen some of our top recommendations for anyone who's taking either piano or keyboard lessons. But my first pick is a bit of an unconventional one, and that's the Carry On Folding Piano 49. Now, if you haven't seen one of these before, do bear with me a little bit. It's not quite as weird and gimmicky as it first looks, and are actually really handy little things to have. So this is a full size, and when I say full size, I mean full size keys, 49 key keyboard, which folds up into something that you can quite easily fit into a bag. Now, obviously I'm not gonna say that this is gonna replace an actual piano with weighted keys or anything like that, but for starting out and just kind of learning the note names and the basic theory behind playing, they're great for that kind of thing. But they also work as a MIDI controller keyboard, so you can plug them into your laptop if you do want to use them for kind of mobile production. They've got a bunch of different sounds on there, including piano, strings, all that kind of thing. We've got rhythms, a metronome, really handy for practicing. Plus, there's a headphone socket, and they even come with a little sustain pedal. Now, I've actually got one of these myself. I've got the 88 note version, which folds up into four sections as opposed to two. But as I mentioned previously, this one's the 49. My kids absolutely love it. They are loads of fun to play at home. But from a serious point of view, they're also a really handy practicing tool that you can take anywhere. If you are looking for a kind of more conventional keyboard to learn the piano on, there's a couple of great options from Alesis, such as this one, which is the Concert 88. So that features 88 full-size keys and a load of different options in terms of sounds and tuition tools. Or for a little bit more money, you can get the Prestige Artist, which offers 88 weighted keys, so it feels a little bit more like a real piano, and you get a few more sounds and a better set of speakers. Yamaha digital pianos such as the P125 and P45 are always great value options which are perfect for beginners, as are the new Casio PX S1000 and S3000, which feature some great feeling keyboards, some really nice lush piano sounds, and they've got a lovely sleek slimline design which is going to look stylish in any home. But don't forget, for any of these kind of portable stage pianos, you probably will need a keyboard stand and a pretty heavy duty one at that. So go for something like this Tortec X stand, which has been double braced so it'll take the weight. Right, so we're nearly at the end of our back to school shopping list, but for any of you drummers out there, don't worry, we haven't forgotten about you. For our final stop, we're heading up into the drum department. So if you ask any drummer, the thing they're going to tell you they need to replace the most is drum sticks, and you can never really have too many pairs in your stick bag. Plus, if you are having drum lessons at school, you'll usually need to take your own pair of sticks with you. If you've not bought a pair of drumsticks before, there is a huge selection available, but you're probably going to want to look out for reputable brands such as Vic Firth, ProMark and Vata. Sticks come in various different lengths, weights and thicknesses, but the most popular type of stick for beginners is either a 5A or a 5B. So a pair of sticks such as these Goodwoods by Vata or Novas by Vic Firth are a great option if you are a beginner, because they're great quality and they're pretty affordable. Or if you're buying a set of sticks for someone else and you don't really know what you're doing, you can't really go wrong with a set like this. Now, for anyone taking drum lessons at school or college, you will probably need to be doing a bit of practice outside of your lessons. But unfortunately, a full-size acoustic kit isn't always practical for home use, as they take up quite a lot of room, and as they're really loud, they do tend to upset the neighbours. Luckily, we do also stock a great selection of electronic drum kits, which are much quieter, so they're a little bit more suitable for playing at home. They're also not as expensive as you might think. You can pick up a pretty decent quality beginner's electric kit for around about £200. Or if you did want something that feels a little bit more realistic, more like a real drum kit, you can get something like this Tortec TT22, which features mesh heads, which feel much more like real drum skins. So if you are looking for an electronic drum kit for home practice, definitely get down to your local PMT store and give one a go. So thanks for watching. That was just a few of our top recommendations for beginners guitars, keyboards and drums. But don't forget, we've got loads more back to school instruments and accessories at your nearest PMT store.
You can also head to pmtonline.co.uk to find out some more information about any of the products we've mentioned in this video. Make sure to head over to our socials at PMT House of Rock and give us a follow.
And if you enjoyed this video, please do give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you again soon.